Okay, we just derived the Pradipadikam Dham Shtra by adding this affix shtran by 3 to 182 to his verbal root dansha. And now we want to use the appropriate feminine affix because this word is used in the feminine in the language. And because this affix shtran has the Murzanya Shakara as 8th letter by Shah Pratyayasya, we have to consider this sutram 4141, which says Shid Gauradibhyascha. It's a very simple sutram. It's the Adhikara of Striyam, which starts from 413. So when we want to use a word in the feminine gender, then we have to pass through the checkpoint. We have to pass through the checkpoint of Striyam, the Adhikara which starts from 413. Now in this Sutram 4141, the Anuvritti of Nish comes from the prior Sutram 4140, Anyato Nish. So what this Sutram says is, Shidbhyo Gauradibhyascha Striyam Nish Syat. So when we want to use a term in the feminine gender, then the affix nish has to be added to a pradipadikam which either contains the Murdhanya Shakara, letter sh as a it, or it belongs to the class of words beginning with Gaura. So the Gaura, etc., they are a class of words listed in a group. It's called the Gaura Diganaha. So when we have Gaura means fair, fair complexion. So Gaura, when we want to use the feminine, we get the form Gauri. We get the form Gauri by this sutram. Shid Gauradibhyascha. So right now what do we have? We have the Pradipadikam Daunshtra ending in the affix Shtran, which does have the Murdhanya Shakara as a it. So by this sutram, Shid Gauradibhyascha, we would have to apply the affix nish to get the appropriate feminine form. But now what happens is that Panini has listed this form Daunshtra in the Ajadiganaha. Let's not forget our Sutram 414, Ajadyatashtap, Ajadyatashtap, which we have of course studied. And that Sutram says that Ajadibhyah Pradipadikebhyah Akarantacha Pradipadikat Striyam Tapratyabhavati. So the Pratyah Tap is added following a Pratipadikam which is either listed in the Ajadiganaha, the list of terms beginning with Aja, etc., or a Pratipadikam which ends in a Akaraha. Right now we do have Dhamstra which ends in a Akaraha, so the affix Tap is applicable. But then Shid Gauradibhyascha says, wait a minute, you have this Murdhanya Shakara as an it, so therefore Nish should be used. But again, this Sutram Ajadyatashtap comes and says that this term Dhamstra is listed specifically in the Ajadiganaha. So therefore, by that specific mention, we have to revert back to Tap and not use Nish. So even though Dhamstra ends in the affix Shtran, which contains the Murdhanya Shakara's it, because Dhamstra is specifically mentioned in the Ajadiganaha, we have to use the affix Tap only and not Nish. So because of that special mention, we use the affix Tap to form the feminine and not the affix Nish, which is prescribed by 4141. So now completing the derivation, we take Dhamstra at Tap by Ajadyatashtap by the special mention of Dhamstra in the Ajadiganaha, and then the rest of it is straightforward. We remove the letters Takarasit Sanya by Chutu and the Pakarasit Sanya Bhalantyam Tasya Lopaha, and then Akasarmadirgha, we get Dhamstra. Dhamstra is the feminine form.